bueno, aquí andamos ahorita por las calles de Tombstone. Aquí nos encontramos los primeros vaqueros. Cuidado, Oscar, no nos vayan a un duelo. Ahorita vamos a recorrer las calles aquí, el centro de Tombstone. Aquí donde hay varios vaqueros. Hombre, ya me está dando miedo un duelo.
You know,
44?
Yeah, vaquero.
Wow.
Yeah. Pretty much everybody that been doing this.
Con cuidado, Oscar, con cuidado. Andan armados. ¿Dónde? Mucho cuidado, Oscar, aquí no das confianza, ¿eh? Si miras que un duelo de volada, como Cantinflas. Vamos a entrar aquí al...
Bueno,
fíjense ustedes la historia aquí. Aquí hubo muchos caídos, dice, en esta barra, en aquellos años, 1880, 1890, como las películas, ¿eh? Aquí se vivió la vida real. Aquí tienen de pistoleros que fueron famosos, mira.
Dice que el 75% de los balaceros pasaban así en las mesas.
Sí.
And you're allowed to take pictures during the show and video the show if you like.
Awesome. Good, awesome.
75, dice que el 75% de las balaceras y todo que hubo aquí, aquí fue en la mesa esa isla donde jugaban barajas, por culpa de las barajas y de las damas. Aquí mismo donde salimos ahorita, un ratito más, van a hacer un show a lo que pasaba, igual a la similar a lo que pasaba ahí en esa barra, en los tiempos aquellos de 1880, 1890. Van a hacer un show ahí, así que vamos a esperar ahorita para mirar. Vamos a andar un poquito aquí mientras, pero para ir a mirar ahí. Dice que es el más real que hay en Arizona. De cómo se agarraban ahí a balazos jugando baraja y todo. Está pesado, está pesado. Aquí caminando por las calles del viejo oeste. Andamos buscando unos sombreros, unas botas ahí porque queremos ponernos. Acá voy. A ver si nos aventamos un duelo ahorita aquí. Pero dicen que son muy buenos para tirar, muy. Vamos a ver. Aquí nos pusimos a discutir aquí con unos señores y según nos van a echar la policía, vamos a ver ahorita a ver si este Oscar a veces pasa porque le dijeron que no se subiera a la carreta y se subió a la carreta a grabar ahí. Y parece que ahí vienen los sheriff. Te dije, Oscar.
Ya, ese va, viejo.
Te dije, Oscar, ya ves. Te dije que no anduviera haciendo eso, pues.
Aquí va a empezar lo bueno ahorita.
Órale.
$8 para sacar a Oscar de aquí de la prisión. Ahí me arrestaron ahorita por culpa del Oscar. Pero voy a contratar unos pistoleros ahora. A ver si es cierto.
Vamos a contratar unos pistoleros, Oscar.
Ahora sí. Vente. 44 Magno.
45, loco.
Oh, 45. Ahora sí, vamos a ver si es cierto. Yo volé. Vamos a ver.
Está.
¿Por qué nos arrestaron por tu culpa?
I'm gonna bring you some luck. That may be the square up at the house, son.
I just ought to take care of it.
Now, hold on just a sec there, Charlie. Only put 3 aces is a mighty strong hand. Unfortunately. And don't beat 4 8s. Excuse me, Charlie, let me get this out of your way.
Short! What is that now? 6 hands in a row? Ain't nobody that lucky.
Nah, Charlie. That's 7 hands in a row. You got something to say?
The bat? I'm just saying, there ain't nobody that lucky.
Charlie, I'll tell you what. How about we take this a little break? Go on a bar and have a drink. Online.
Now that sounds like a good idea.
I believe I can afford it now.
You just gotta keep stoking that fire, don't you?
Come on, bat. You know what's in there, Zane. Right, Charlie.
What about there, Charlie?
That's him up all around, not me.
All around, not you.
Yeah, with my money.
Keep it up, Charlie. Well, Pat, sure looks like these cards are loving me again today, don't it?
Yeah, Luke. You always seem to win.
Yeah, I do, don't I? It's true, Charlie.
Yeah, you always seem to win. Win. You're dealing the cards!
That's it. That's the obvious. It's gone on long enough. Storms, I've had a belly full of your gas. I told you once. You got something on your mind. You best spit it out.
Those slick hands. Loose lips. Gonna get you down.
I am.
Now, the next time I come into town, I best be getting me some respect. And Milt, I'll be taking this here bottle.
You do what you want, TJ.
And that mine, I'll be keeping it for myself. We ain't partners no more.
Yeah, I'm all right, but he ain't gonna be.
Where you getting at, Mel? Oh, you don't need a gun, Brad. Come on, Mel. Brad, don't do it. TJ.
Oh, listen, don't forget about old man Lewis. $3 for that chair we busted up last night.
I don't know what we're going to do to that old man.
I don't either. I got his gun. He don't get it back until he pawns out the money. All right. Max, put yourself down $10.
Max, $10. $10? Who says I owe $10?
Last night, Marshall would have tossed you in jail and thrown away the key if I hadn't. Talked
him
out of it.
But I was only.
Am I gonna have a problem with you?
Not one little bit. Well, you've got that thing.
Yeah.
Rich, get me a drink.
I don't think so, Billy. You've had enough to drink already. Well, get out of here. Walk it. Oh, Max, I want you to get rid of that piano player. I don't like
him. Get rid of him? Frank, he's only been here a couple weeks.
I don't care how long he's been here. Besides that, he's all thumbs. And girls don't like him either. I'll get rid of him. But I want you to go across the street to Crystal Palace. Now, that guy they hired a couple months ago, I hear tell you he ain't real happy over there. I bet he'd love to come over here and play piano at my place. You go talk to him.
I'll go talk to him, Frank, but you know what happened last time he stole a piano player from there? It got real ugly.
I
I didn't care then, I don't care now. They'll get over it. Oh, listen, while you're over there, I want you to talk to that big money Russian. You know the one I'm talking about? Was that silly white top hat girl?
I know who you're talking about.
I want you to go talk to her. See if we can't get him to come over here and do some gambling at my place.
Frank, what do we want him here for?
Because he's a lousy poker player. He's got a lot of that Russian gold. I aim to take it from him.
Now you're talking, Frank.
Frank, get me a drink. Billy, I told you once you've had enough to drink. I ain't going to tell you again. Go on, get out of here. What are you standing there looking at me for? Don't you understand English? Sit, kid.
Yeah. Miss Nelly, she's been telling me he's been on a 3-day bender.
Well, that don't surprise me about that.
Drunken wretch.
One more thing, Max. I want you to get rid of Margarita.
Margarita, what for?
Because she's a sloppy drunk with a big mouth. By 12 o'clock, she's useless. So get rid of her.
All right, but who do you want me to get to replace her?
What's the name of that little redhead over there at the bunker to play?
Mary.
Mary. She's cute. She knows her job. She'll make me lots of money.
You got her.
Wait a minute. On second thought, I want you to get Gold Dog.
Frank.
You can't get Gold Dollar.
Why not?
If you put Gold Dollar and Margarita in the same building,
someone's going to get dead.
You give me Gold Dollar.
Drink. Give me a drink.
Now, Billy, I done told you twice you had enough to drink. Don't make me tell you, you gotta go on, get out.
Frank, if you'll give me a drink, I'm gonna tell him and him and everybody else in this whole stinking town what you done to my friend Johnny.
Oh, that's it, Billy.
Watch him, Frank. He's got a pistol on him.
You know, my saloon with a gun on. I said, get
him. Nobody. Nobody manhandles Billy Claiborne like that.
I just did, Billy.
Frank, you forget. I was at the OK Corral.
Yeah, you were at the corral, all right.
Till the bullets started flying. And you ran like a little coward you are.
I ain't running now, Frank. I'm going to get me another gun. I'm coming for you, Leslie.
Bill, you do yourself a favor. Go on home, sleep it off.
No, Frank, this ain't over. Not by a long shot.
The heck am I going to do with that man?
I don't know, Frank.
But you better take you something fast. Billy's been hanging out with them cowboys again. Trying to make himself a big name.
Max, that man got the brass to come back in here.
I don't know, Frank. Remember now, he killed that Hickey feller down there in Charleston, and he is just drunk enough to try that again.
All right, Max, you better go out to Billy. Make sure he stays out of here. Because if not, it's going to be his blood on the floor. That man's going to get himself killed one of these days.
Max!
Billy, I knew you'd be out here, but I was sure hoping you weren't.
Max, I've come to kill him. Nobody calls Billy Claiborne a coward and gets away with it.
Billy, if you go back in there, that man's going to kill you. Now give me that pistol.
I have a better idea. Why don't you go back in there and tell Buck and Frank Leslie that me, Billy Claiborne, is out here waiting on him.
Billy, if Frank comes out here, he's going to burn you.
Just go. Tell him.
All right, Billy, I'll tell him.
Max, you fine, Billy?
Yeah,
he's out there. Says he's going to kill you.
What? Billy's saying that? Come on, Max, you know Billy. He'll go home and sleep it off, sober up, forget all about it. Hell, I wouldn't pay him a minute, man.
Not this time, Frank. He's calling you out.
Billy Claiborne's calling me out? My God, that man never learns, does he?
Now, Frank, you be careful you go out there. Billy's went and found himself and got a pistol and he's fixing to use it on you.
Well, we'll just see about that. Billy Claiborne, where you at, son? Come on out now, Billy. I don't want to have to kill you.
Leslie!
Si te gustan mis videos, da like, suscríbete y comparte. Y seguiremos juntos siendo parte de estas exploraciones y aventuras. Gracias.